Hi my people, welcome to our new video. So today we're going to show you how to fix one of the most disturbing issues of the PDF libraries. It's gonna be here. You can see it says uncaught exception FPDF error unsupported image type PNG, right? These two, I made a video on how to fix this. This also, I made a video on how to fix this. Don't worry about anything here. We're gonna worry about only this error. So right, so what we're going to do is the reason why you're getting this, the image when it's being received by the code, it can't be interpreted like the way it should be. So now we're gonna try our tricks without touching the file. This is the file it complains about, though the image is not in the same file. The file is called fpdf.php, but we're not going to touch that file, right? We're going to prepare our code so well to the standards whereby it should interpret the image well. So the image should show. Here, one of the tricks I'm going to do, I'm going to use what they call var dump. When we use this function inside here, I'm gonna say see me, right? After seeing me, I put this and I take exactly this image and I put it here. After saving, can't get anything here. I wonder what went where. Okay, right, it needs a comma and a colon, whatever. Save, semicolon, and refresh again. When we refresh, it says see me string status, the picture is here, right? So since this is the picture they show us, truly HTML or any other code should take this and understand that this is a picture. Then what's gonna happen, we're gonna take this picture and we put it where we get a prompt. Where do we get a prompt? Here we get a prompt whereby we call this picture, not this picture, the one I put. The one I put, it says if we don't get a picture in the database, we should show the picture in a specific folder to replace the one in the database. Well, that works perfectly, and to prove it, I'm gonna copy the same thing. Remember we put it here and it showed the name. The picture to work, it should show only the name of the picture, nothing more, nothing less. Then we're going to go here and we find the line in PHP and FPDF where we display the picture. This is the picture which does not work. It's here. I'm taking it out and replace it with the one we saw. We did var dump and it worked. Once we save that, it's gonna be super good for us to understand that the picture's working, and we have to play and a trick to make sure also the same another picture shows. Once I press that, I receive the same a good picture which I intended to receive. Well, we go here and we find which picture which doesn't show, and we want to find out why. This is the picture from the database which does not show. I embedded it in here, like as you say, SR source whatever, but it doesn't show. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna copy this same picture, copy it, put it here in here, and see if it's gonna show. So I'm using VATdump to show that. So still I want to avoid the picture we put to show, because it's going not to give me what I need. Let me put the picture which gives us more stress. I'm gonna say okay, and I save. Well, the picture comes, but as a picture which is wrong. We need to see the name, so it comes as a picture here on VATdump. Remember the first one, it says show me, see me, and it gave us the picture name. It did not display. Well, that's where we find the issue. So since the issue is there, the picture which shows on the PDF should also have the picture which doesn't show on the PDF, which is giving us a trouble. This one should have the same behaviors with the picture which shows. The picture which shows is this one, but when we put it here, you're gonna see what we get. What we get is what we have to fight to get the same result, like the one which doesn't show, one which shows. You can see we must get a picture. Do VATdump and see if you can get the same name. You must get a name, you get me. So the name of the picture and its extension in two quotes simply means your FPDF can show that if you get this. So VATdump helped me to know that there is a difference between these two pictures. So what I did is to delete, I'm deleting this and that, then plus this here, then I'm gonna VATdump this. Well, I'm gonna VATdump that, and I'm going to, since it's gonna work, I know I'm going to stop this line so that you see the behaviors should be the same as the previous one. It should show the name, not the picture here. Since I took out that problem, it just goes straight, and I'm going to show you it works, but I wanted the error more than the working thing. Let me save. It's gonna display the image from the database. Here is the image we see, but that's not the image we should see. I'm gonna get you the image we should see. Let me see. The first image here, let me see, VATdump rear logo. This is the image we see here. Let me see if we can put it in quotes and we see, get something better. Give us some trouble, but let's try to VATdump that. You see, me, if we VATdump that, we don't get it, which is super super crazy. So what we need to do, we need to get this, as I told you, Okay, let me try to get this. If you get a name, then it should show. Gonna go here. And I save. Okay. Yes, this is what I wanted. You can see that the picture shows us that with the extension. This is what we get. So fight harder to remove the extension, right? Once you remove the extension, then you're gonna be good to go. Remember, our picture cannot show in PDF if the extension comes with it. It should be stripped out to get things right. Okay, if I do this and I save, I might see different results. Okay, it doesn't get the picture I want, it gives me something else. So now what I'm going to do is to still, since I get that, I'm gonna get this photo, and if I say, remember, this is gonna come from the database. So what I should do, I shouldn't take this photo. I should go and get the database picture name, which is the logo here, and concatenate it here with the target. Target is the folder, but this is the picture name. Then it's gonna go to the folder and get it and display it for us. We should show that picture now. So I have managed to show it. Simple. Now you can see, we can see the picture which we intended to get, right? Guys, please don't forget to subscribe. The only trick I did is to use Verdamp. Your picture to show, it should, let me go back, your picture to show, it should give you this. Let me show you. Okay, instead of that, the picture is not going to show. If you see, it skipped it because it got what? It went to the database and show something else. But I wanna get the errors, and I wanna get you into some errors, and you're gonna see what's gonna happen. You see your picture to show. If you said Verdamp, it shouldn't come with this folder where it comes from. It should come only this. Find a way to only display the name and the extension. To do that, it's gonna be easy for me. That's why you saw and I showed you that I'm gonna get the logo only. I'm gonna get the logo. And once I get the logo, I'm gonna put it here to show you that it works. That logo is gonna be there, but don't worry about the display of the picture. You see the logo, that's the logo I wanted. It comes without the target. Since it doesn't come with the target, now to display, I need to put it here. And since I put it here, I should delete these quotes. Okay. Well, save that. And move on. When you refresh, we see the picture. Thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to subscribe. If you have any question, please leave it in the comment box below. We are here to help you and you are there to support us. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video. I hope that helps, guys. Don't forget to comment and also press that button which looks like a bell.